Good.
Well, hi, I'm Celine Scott, and I'm going to tell you about how I started my business. I was about 23 years old and just had my second little child. He was a newborn. And at that time, I was a stay-at-home mom, and I just felt like there was so much more to my life that that I wanted to do. And so I did have a background in interior design, so that was what kind of my calling was. I took a little bit of money that I had stashed away and saved up, and I ended up going to an auction. This was an auction that sold art pieces and new furniture from furniture distributors. And I did this kind of just on the thought of maybe I'll just, you know, buy something inexpensive and then resell it. Well, I got there and my eyes kind of got big and I looked around and saw all the neat, exciting things. And I picked out a few key pieces that I liked and purchased them, brought them home, and rearranged my whole entire living room to put these new pieces in there and staged them beautifully. The art pieces, the little accessories and pillows and rugs. And I made a whole little room of it. Photographed it beautifully and put it in the local newspaper classifieds. I just put it for a little bit of a markup, thinking that, well, if I just make a little bit of money off of it, I get my enjoyment and it'll pay for my time. Within a day, I had multiple phone calls and had people come out to my house and purchase the entire room full of things just as I had it staged and set up. Funny side note, one of my first clients that actually came to my home was the president of the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. So right away I was drawing really interesting people that I got to work with. So I took that money that I had made from flipping the first room of furniture, and I went back down to the auction the next week. Still hadn't really talked to anybody in my family about what I was doing because I didn't really sure what I was doing. I was just kind of moving in a direction. Got back down to the auction, purchased a whole nother set of furniture, completely different this time, did the same thing, hauled it home in my truck, had a couple friends help me unload everything, haul it into my house, set everything up, did the photographs again and had them in the newspaper again for that next Monday morning. And sure enough, within a day, I had people phone ringing off the hook and people coming back out and purchasing the whole room full of furniture. I did spend a lot of time in the photographing and the lighting, so it did look very beautiful. It wasn't just randomly people were choosing to come out there. But the people that did come, they appreciated the time I spent in putting together this look that they probably wouldn't have been able to create themselves. So that's why it was special to them.
So what gave you that vision to even do that, to take that first step?
You know, I just felt like I needed to do something, and I did the only thing I knew how to do, which was something I was good at. So I took my gift, which was interior design, and I was looking for any pieces I could put together and anybody who wanted to know about it.
And so what made you go to that first step to put this in a newspaper, to set it up in your house, and then to go ahead?
Well, we had a little bit prior to that sold, I believe, a refrigerator in the classified section. And so I went through the process. And so I had that in the back of my mind and I thought, well, I have this great product. How do I get it out to somebody? Okay. So it was kind of a trial and error. And I just got lucky on the first shot that people actually went to the classified section to purchase sofas. And that's what I was advertising.
Okay.
Weekly, it became a routine now for me to go to the auction and start purchasing. What was happening was my people who would come to purchase the rooms for my house would say, well, Celine, can you get me anything else? I have my bedroom I'd like you to do. And so I started having more of a demand, and I was having to look around, look at other sources and resources to be purchasing product for these people. And they were also then hiring out design services from me too. So this was a weekly thing, going down to the auctions. And within 3 months, I ended up meeting a lady who came out to my house to purchase furniture that just had purchased a very large vacation property. It was an apartment complex she wanted to turn into these vacation condos, and ended up hiring me to do the entire project, from the blueprints with the builders to furnishing the entire, I believe it was 40 units of condos fully furnished with furniture. So when I got that contract, I started thinking, well, this just is not going to fit in my house if I ship everything here. So the next step was I thought, well, I'll just get a small little warehouse so that I can receive her things into
it. And all this vision came from you selling a refrigerator.
All from the refrigerator, yep. And then things just started happening really quickly, and I'm thinking, well, I better just keep moving. If I keep moving in a direction, at least we're going somewhere.
God, it's so good.
Exactly. So we got the little warehouse unit, and then I was thinking, well, I don't know how long it will take me to collect 42 units worth of furniture from just going to auctions. I got to have other places to buy the furniture from. So I went around and I found 3 furniture vendors who would sell to me wholesale and ship right to the warehouse there. And that's how the business started. Shortly after that, about a month after that, I did open a showroom there. And
wow.
It just started taking off. Within a year, we were doing over $1 million in revenue.
Wow. And it started from that refrigerator to you going to this auction and staging this furniture in your house.
In my house. And a little less than $1,000 of money that I had saved up on my own.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. So that's so good. So so after you got the contract with the woman to do that, then you eventually open up your own store.
Yeah,
tell me a little about that.
Well, actually, what happened was another blessing. In the randomness of picking the warehouse that I picked, it was actually in this big strip mall location. And shortly after we did the project, the unit next to the warehouse moved out. So we were able to actually knock down the walls and take over that space, which became my showroom. And then over the course of that year, we ended up taking over 4 more units. So it ended up being quite a large showroom. It was a 10,000 square foot interior design studio. We had over 130 different vendors after about a 4-year period. I offered wholesale prices to the public, free design services, and you know, it was amazing. I got to live my dream. And the funny thing is every day you go to work and you never know which direction it's going to go, what's going to walk into the door, what new contract it's going to be. So it was really a blessing.
So what would you tell the women who want to start a business? What would you tell them just in a short sentence or so?
Discover what it is about you that you really love and you're really gifted at and love to do, and walk towards it.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.